Elliot Mintz, a sound portrait. TK.
Allow us to introduce a digital artist and visionary, a man who sculpts with binary, paints with hues of electronic color and light, a man who brings sound and images to people globally. Meet TK, the web designer, producer, and editor of ElliotMintz.com. His work on ElliotMintz.com has created a journey, an adventure. He has created more than simply another stop on the information superhighway. If the internet is a yellow brick road, TK has designed the Emerald City. He did so with a portable virtual jukebox full of magic and entertainment. Magic indeed is what he has done. He has resurrected many old tapes, some unmarked, containing interviews, music, and memories. And he arranged them in the halls of ElliotMintz.com for visitors to enjoy wherever they may be. Let's meet the man behind the curtains, TK.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome our special guest, TK. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Paul. I'm glad to be here.
All right, it's a pleasure. You could say that you're in part the mastermind behind this website, ElliotMintz.com, and it is quite a website. How did you...
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you, actually. How did you learn about this web and media artistry?
Oh, those are... I picked up a number of skills when I was working for a recording artist for many years. I don't live in LA anymore, but I lived in Los Angeles for a good 15 years, and most of that time I worked for a recording artist who was signed to Interscope Records. She never really went anywhere, but I worked for her for many years, and I was basically her sound engineer at the beginning. But then I basically, because I was the only person on her personal staff, I picked up all the other skills. I learned how to edit video. I learned how to not only do music, but other kinds of audio editing and sound design. And then eventually when we started to go on the internet, I learned how to do websites and all her social media and how to hack the MySpace page. And I learned Flash. And so I got into coding as well. And that also ties into web design. There's a lot of coding in it. And so I just picked up all these skills one by one just in a course of working as her, like, I was also her system administrator as well. I mean, it was kind of like the Johnny of all trades.
When I've interviewed Elliot, for anyone who's kind of just a curiosity seeker here, who's checking this out, who is this Elliot Mintz?
Well, as the website sort of is a roundabout way of a memoir of him. You know, he didn't want to write a traditional memoir, and he doesn't like to write in books in general. But he had all this stuff on tape, different media, sound and video and such. He has piles of it from way back. And so the site itself kind of, if it taken as a whole, it takes you through a great part of his whole adulthood, really. And it's, you can see who he is from the site. You know, you get to know him. He's an interesting character that's been in the thick of the American entertainment industry, really. I mean, it's centered in Los Angeles. He's kind of been in the middle of it for a long time and very close to it. And thus, since so many of us are also fascinated with celebrity and entertainment, that he himself has become, an interesting figure in and of himself.
How did you come to meet Elliot Mintz?
Through actually another person I think you'll be interviewing, Jim Ladd, the DJ from Los Angeles. I was introduced to Elliot through Jim because I had, incidentally, Jim had given me my first big break on the internet design stage when he just tapped me to design his MySpace page. It turned out really well. Everybody liked it. So I was kind of referred by a mutual friend of Jim and Elliot's to Elliot, who was looking to make a website and was having trouble finding the right person to do it. So it was a friend of a friend thing.
Interesting. When you first met Elliot Mintz, what was your first impression?
Oh, it's the first meeting with Elliot, sometimes it's kind of a, it's to impress a little bit. He has you drive up to his house up on Mulholland Drive. It's a very treacherous and beautiful drive up there, and beautiful home and overlooking the city. It's for just a kind of like a poor boy like me, and that was kind of impressive. You know, this seemed to suggest this is kind of a big time. And but he's very well-mannered and kind and generous. Of course, he was a friend of a friend, so I was at ease anyway. But just a genteel, intelligent man. That's my first impression.
One of the things that people can find on this website, ElliotMintz.com, is they can find these interviews. There's a collection of them. And my understanding is a lot of these interviews were old tapes. How did you go about getting them in a format where they could be heard on the website?
Those tapes took a pretty long journey even before I started working for Elliot. He used to have them, he salvaged a number of them. A lot of them were lost. So he's got like a fraction of what he used to have. He used to have like reel-to-reel audio tape, a lot of it, like a big pile of it. And at one point, he had a secretary or someone who was working for him transfer it all to VHS. And then another person, even later down the line, recorded off the VHS into digital files. And that's what I inherited at that point. But at that point, it was basically a mountain of huge files with no catalog, nothing. It was a blind mountain of material that we had to pick through by hand. That's part of what took so long to make the site. It's from what Elliot tells me, there's even more still sitting in boxes.
Amazing.
So it's not over yet.
Well, in addition to just what you said about these unmarked tapes, what was the biggest challenge you faced to get ElliotMintz.com live?
It was organizational challenge, logistically, and because he had, and that's just one example, that mountain of tape, there's stuff from all over the place, and we worked on it for over a long period of time, and there are many revisions to some of the work, and then at some point, we had other people involved, other production crews. When he did those interviews in his living room, we had production crews from the outside we were working with, and so we were constantly having to adapt to other teams and getting stuff from them and then doing our edits. And like I said, after a while, we started having multiple versions of things and you start losing track. And over time, you realize that you should have been more organized in the beginning. But we finally ironed it out. But yeah, the biggest challenge was in keeping it organized, finding everything. Often Elliot would say, I know there's this interview, I've heard it, we could, you know, it would be a difficult job to find it. So there was a lot of organizational challenge there. And that's part of what took so long, too.
What was one of the ideas that you had that was like a light bulb that went off that has added to this project?
A lot of what I added was small suggestions here and there. But I guess going back to the very beginning, you know, what we started with like a blank slate. What would the website be? What would it look like? What would be on it? Actually, I was inspired partly by his living room and the scene over the city that you see out his patio window, that in which you see behind him and some of the interviews on the site. It reminded me of the backdrop on like the Tonight Show or something, where there's, you see the city behind the desk. And of course, that's in one of Elliot's, the Mintz on Mintz interview. You see him just like that. He's sitting in a chair and you see the city behind him. And so that it seemed natural to just set it as if you're sitting in the living room, his living room, like just watching home movies, which you kind of are in many cases. And we just kind of put the Wurlitzer thing on top of it. So some of that stuff, there's a germ of it there that I kind of pitched to him, but it really came off of what I found material, his living room, his love of the jukebox.
Our special guest is TeKay, one of the web and media masterminds behind the website ElliotMintz.com. What, in your opinion, is the most interesting part of the website?
Well, what I find very quite fascinating are the collection of radio interviews, what's called radio interviews on the site. What I was struck with is, I ended up listening to all of it with Elliot in the course of editing it, of course, and I was kind of struck at how not only how Elliot as a skilled interviewer could get these people to open up at length and with being so candid and forthcoming and it was surprised me how that radio used to be this way. When I hear people in interviews today, everything's rushed, everything's prepared. There's a veneer that you need to pierce to try to even figure out what the sincerity is. But in these interviews that I, you know, from 30, 40 years ago, there's all this, like I said, they're candid, they're honest, they're not guarded at all. They're complete and they're completely open. And it fascinated me. It blew me away. It's like, wow, I wish it was still like that. And of course, you're hearing some of these subjects, very famous, very revered people, and you hear them speaking so clearly and honestly and at length. It's really just a breath of fresh air, and it's a delight to hear it.
I have to say, I concur with you about what radio used to be and what it could, what it still could be.
Yeah, that's what these podcasts are becoming, I guess.
What is Elliot Mintz like to work with?
Thankfully, very easy to work with. You know, I worked a long time with him, and it would have been terrible if he was any less wonderful to work with. He's easygoing. He likes to take his time. He never works on weekends. You know, it makes it easy. Elliot is a perfectionist in a way, so but that's fine. I know I'm cool with that. I think that's, you know, I'd rather have a work for a perfectionist than someone that really doesn't care and just wants to rush something out. I take pride in the work just as much as he does, and he couldn't be more easy, kinder and gentler and more understanding person to work with. It just took a little longer, that's all.
One thing that I think is definitely true, there are not many people who could argue with the notion that Elliot Mintz has led a very interesting life. Why do you think he has lived such an interesting life?
I guess, you know, number one, there's the proximity factor. You know, I forget who said the saying that success is 80% showing up or something. Elliot has been right in there. He was interviewing people, authors, actors, musicians. So he was constantly being exposed to those people. And he lived in Laurel Canyon. All his neighbors were all rock stars and stuff. He was just there. When you show up and you're there, you're witness to all that great stuff that happened. And also, as you hear evidence in a lot of his interviews, he's got a lot of very natural curiosity and fascination and enthusiasm that really brings out a lot of stuff in the people he's interviewing. And that also keeps him engaged. People trust him. He's friends with everyone of a certain out there. And so it's just being there, being engaged, and being cool. I think it just keeps you in the game.
Tell me about some of the people you met as a result of doing this project, ElliotMintz.com.
We did a few things. I mean, basically the subjects he had in his living room. Those were the more interesting, meeting Sean Lennon, Marianne Williamson. Those were cool people, and it was kind of interesting to film them and stuff. Yeah, those are probably what I would say are the more interesting aspects.
Of those fireside chats that he had, was there one that you thought was especially interesting?
I like the Sean one, Sean Lennon, just because it was, he and Elliot are so familiar in almost a familial way. It's not like another interview. It's almost, they have like a shorthand going on and a wink, wink. It's very entertaining to watch. I'd say that one is the most interesting one to me.
What is the best thing about being TK?
I guess TK itself is like a persona in a sense. It goes back to the early days of social media on MySpace. I picked a persona. I stylized it. So TK is really kind of like a enhanced version of me. And I kind of like that. I like keeping it separate from my own identity. So I like the anonymity of TK. And he can be like the cooler version of this other guy that I don't think people would be as interested in.
Oh, yeah. One more thing. This is kind of it's something I noticed the other day. On the website, when you click on the little statue in the corner, I believe it turns into Buddha.
Yeah.
What's that all about?
Actually, where that came from is just in the beginning, we were making a little living room scene. We're changing around. Elliot has those two statues that you see in his living room. He actually owns those. So we had the two photographs, and we're like, which one do you want to put in this corner and he couldn't decide. So I just said, oh, you know what, I'll just put one in there, but I'll make it so if you click on it, it just flips to the other one. just for the heck of it, just to leave it at rest for a while. But, and we never returned to it. It just stayed that way.
And now we know.
It's a secret link there.
I keep thinking there has to be an Easter egg somewhere.
Well, we may add one or two. Who knows?
Well, TK, thank you very much for this interview.
Yeah, you're very welcome, Paul.
All right. You have a wonderful evening.
You too.